Hi, I'm Sandon Jacobs from Confluent, and I'm here to tell you all about the latest release of Apache Kafka version 4.1. This release includes 19 kips from the Kafka community. And while the bulk of this release is focused on hardening all that goodness from the recent 4.0 release, I think you'll find something new in here for just about everyone in the data streaming space. So let's just get into it, shall we? Let's start with KIP 932, Queues for Kafka, which makes the move to preview thanks in large part to feedback from the community during the early access phase in Kafka 4.0. This KIP introduces a new way to consume messages in Kafka, enabling share groups and share consumers. Unlike your traditional consumer groups, these share consumers cooperate to process messages from the same topic partition. This decouples your consumers from the number of partitions of your topic. This means you've got more flexibility in how you scale consumer workloads. But that doesn't come without some trade-offs, namely ordering guarantees, meaning you can't totally be sure that messages in a partition will be processed strictly in the order they were produced. But in your queuing use cases, you don't always need that strict ordering, right? What you really want is a guarantee that you can acknowledge events individually as they're being processed. And that's different from your traditional stream processing use cases. And you also want to be able to scale your processing a little more elastically. In the Java client, share groups are implemented in a new consumer class, as you can see here. From the terminal, there's new Kafka CLI tools for consuming data using a share group and managing those share groups. And of course, the admin client includes methods for managing share groups as well. It wouldn't do for these new features to be invisible to you operators, so new metrics have been added for monitoring and scaling purposes. Now, in the case you want fine-grained control over the lifecycle of each individual message, this release gives you explicit acknowledgement functionality. Here's an example of the share consumer API where we use a new configuration parameter called share acknowledgement mode, and we set that value to explicit. Then we try to process each message. In the go write path, we call the acknowledge method on the consumer to accept a message. If there's an exception, we might use the release or reject acknowledgement types on that individual message. Look for more enhancements on KIP 932 and future releases. KIP 1139 introduces native OAuth JWT bearer grant support for Apache Kafka clients. Why? Well, before we relied on static username and password credentials when using authorization, which worked, but it's a little bit old-fashioned. JWT bearer tokens from an existing OAuth 2 or OIDC identity provider are a bit more standard now. This means you can drop the long-lived static credentials and use a more up-to-date authentication method, which will probably integrate better with the identity management systems your cloud provider wants you to use anyway. As for your Kafka clients, your identity provider will have documentation on how to find the settings you need. Then you'll need to add those details to your Kafka client configuration. Now that client application can securely connect to your Kafka cluster. And wait for it. This is available to both Java and non-Java clients. Now, you probably thought I was going to say libRD-based users would have to wait for the next release, but no. It's all supported starting right now. For Kafka Streams developers, the early access release of KIP 1071 brings broker-driven rebalancing to your applications. The lessons of KIP 848 are being applied here to your Kafka Streams applications. Now, if you don't remember from Kafka 4.0 release, this moves consumer group rebalance coordination from your clients to your brokers. And this is a part of an overall trend to make it easier for your managed Kafka providers to be more useful, a part of Kafka's continuing evolution towards being truly cloud native. With KIP 1071, the broker will coordinate task assignments and rebalancing decisions in a streams optimized fashion, separate from the traditional consumer group protocols. And it's going to use a new group protocol value for that called, you guessed it, streams. There are new operations in the admin API to describe streams groups, as well as a new CLI script. As for monitoring, there's new broker side metrics that bring a clear protocol separation between your traditional consumers, your share groups, and now your streams. And this is just gonna make it easier for you to differentiate between the consumers of your data streams. Better task level visibility in my Kafka Streams applications? Yes, please, sign me up. Now a disclaimer, this is for testing environments only. This is still pre-release and some features of Kafka Streams aren't supported just yet. Things like static membership, topology updates, and regex for topic subscriptions. The API and the configuration will probably see some changes before general availability, but don't let that stop you from experimenting and providing feedback on this kip to help shape its future. The 4.1 release improves on the foundation of the 4.0 release from earlier this year. Work continues on KIP 848, the new consumer group protocol, with broker and client enhancements for broker-driven rebalancing, making that process faster and more stable. KIP 890 continues the work on transaction server-side defense to improve transaction behavior and correctness. These latest changes build on the work from phase 1 in Kafka 3.x and phase 2 from Kafka 4.0. KIP 853 introduces dynamic voters to KRAP membership controls. KIP 1050, a unified strategy for error handling for transactions. Exceptions are categorized into these four types: producer retryable, producer recoverable, application recoverable, and invalid configuration. The main goals here are to 1, simplify your error handling, and 2, provide some clarity in your client code around error messaging. With KIP 1111, Kafka Streams developers will see more user-friendly naming for internal topics. You've probably seen these left zero padded numbers in the naming convention of internal topics. That's the position of the topic within the topology. But what if we refactored or updated the topology? Well, this could potentially cause a loss of internal state. KIP 1111 enforces explicit naming for those internal topics in your Kafka Streams topologies. KIP 1109 brings uniformity, dare I say sanity, to the naming convention of consumer topic metrics. Producers and consumers have used different naming conventions for topic names within their metrics. Specifically, consumers would replace the periods in a topic name with underscores when it produced the metrics. Confusing? A little bit. Well, this KIP is a first step towards clearing this confusion. New consumer metrics will be emitted alongside the existing ones, with those legacy consumer metrics being marked as deprecated. This should provide a smooth migration path, and these legacy metrics will likely be removed in a later release. And those are the highlights of Apache Kafka version 4.1. Now, there's a lot more meat on the bone than I can cover here, so I encourage you to go check out the release notes. Thanks for watching, and as always, we look forward to seeing the awesome things you're going to build.